Hello and welcome to another special, today on location in London. And what better place to start than here, overlooking the River Thames. The view along the river is a history lesson in itself. London is known for its pomp and circumstance and is one of the great cities of the world, renowned as a tourism, cultural and business centre. Today, throughout the programme, we'll be taking a look at a variety of well-known landmarks. But first, let's take a look at this.
London. Millions of people have giggled and shouted their way through the city by a dice on the Monopoly board, landing on many of the most famous streets in the world. This fun-filled evening, however, doesn't come close to preparing you for the heady experience of visiting London itself. It's hard to pinpoint what makes this ancient city so special. Is it the rich and diverse history, where every corner you turn, you'll come across another building or monument honouring a character or event you've read about since childhood? Who can explain the thrill of walking through the Tower of London, knowing it was this very spot where Guy Fawkes and Anne Boleyn suffered the same deadly fate? No wonder London is the fashion and food capital of the world. Here you can dine in Covent Gardens to the background of opera singing, do some star spotting in trendy Soho, or picnic in one of the many expansive parks which are dotted around the city. Fashionistas will be transported to heaven when they scour the shops at Carnaby Street and the brand new Kingly Court with their eclectic mix of up-and-coming designers. Find a bargain at the markets on Portobello Road or soak in the Cher opulence at Harrods department store. Of course, Buckingham Palace never fails to produce an awe-inspiring effect, especially when a royal parade is in progress and the royals and guards are dressed in their full regalia. And for literature enthusiasts, you'll be transported back in time when you visit the Globe Theatre, where the masterpieces of Shakespeare were very first brought to life. And thanks to government legislation, you can now take the family to famous museums and art galleries absolutely free. Now, if you've ever wondered where we get the precise time from, it's here at Greenwich. Lying on the south bank of the Thames, Greenwich provides London's nautical heritage. One of the great tourist attractions is the Royal Observatory, where you can stand astride longitude zero with one foot in the eastern and one in the western hemisphere. And of course, it's here where Greenwich Mean Time originates. So when you visit, make sure you put your watch in sync. You could explore different sites and attractions for months and still have only scratched the surface. You can pick up details on all that London has to offer through visitlondon.com, which is of course what you must do if you haven't already.
Well, behind me you'll see what makes England tick, literally. There's the British Parliament, and standing watch over it is Big Ben. The 316-foot clock tower was completed in 1859 and boasts some impressive statistics. The clock mechanism alone weighs 5 tonnes and the copper minute hands are 14 feet or over 4 metres long. And you'll know when all the important decisions are being made as a light above the clock is lit while the House of Commons is sitting. Back here in London, this very impressive tourist attraction is the London Eye. It's got fabulous views in every direction, and you can see for miles. Built to commemorate the new millennium, it was a major architectural feat in itself. And now tourists from all over the world flock to take the breathtaking ride that takes in all the sights of this magnificent city. If you're coming to London, put this attraction on the top of your list. It's well worth the ride. Now, if you'd like to tread where royalty has, take a trip here to Westminster Abbey, founded by Edward the Confessor in 1065. All coronations since Norman times have taken place in the Abbey, but not all kings have been buried here, and none since George II in 1760. However, within the Abbey walls rest an impressive repertoire of names from Mary Queen of Scots, Richard II and Elizabeth I. But it's not just royalty that have been buried at Westminster Abbey. The Poets' Corner contains the tombs of Chaucer, Browning, Tennyson and many other famous writers. And on Sundays there's a wonderful opportunity to be part of a very moving Christian service. Well, here's another walk down memory lane, not only for me, but for the tens of thousands of Australians over the years that have called Earl's Court home. Commonly referred to as Kangaroo Valley, Earl's Court has been a mecca for Australian travellers since the 1940s. No one's quite sure why Aussies were drawn to this location, but tradition has continued over the years and it still remains a base for many who set out to see the world.
Something like this is integral to the London British way of life.
It's very different from English food. Believe it or not, but afterwards your fingers smell nice for like 2 or 3 days.
I'm always here with my friends, hanging around, playing pool, having fun, drinking, you know, dancing. It's really cool.
It's great! I have my yellow stilettos, matching ribbons. I love it. It's a good excuse to dress up for the boys.
I love music. It's an international language like sex and money.
Kingsley Court is one of the most diverse places in London at the moment, because I really do believe it is the fashion of the future.
The skate scene in London at the moment is pretty big, and it's getting bigger.
It's a fantastic place. You know, there's history, there's great people, there's fantastic places to go and visit. And, you know, on a sunny day, you can't beat London. The parks, the people, the smells, the little squirrels, the birdies, the bus drivers, the red route masters, the chirpy cab drivers, it's all here.
This is the famous Nelson's Column in Trafalgar Square. The 6-metre statue of Nelson surmounting a 60-metre Devon granite column designed to commemorate Lord Nelson's victory and death in the Battle of Trafalgar on October 21st, 1805. Trafalgar Square is named after the Spanish Cape Trafalgar, where the battle was won, and is not only a tourist attraction, but a gathering place for all Britons. The bird life, a never-failing attraction for adults and children alike. The four giant bronze lions guarding its base were designed in 1868, while the water fountains followed much later and were completed in 1948. Next year is the 200th anniversary of the Battle of Trafalgar. Some big celebrations are planned, so I talked with the director of the National Maritime Museum at Greenwich, Stephen Riley.
2005 is going to be a really important year for us here in the UK. It's both the bicentenary of the Battle of Trafalgar and the death of Nelson. And of course, Nelson is probably our greatest national hero. But it's also going to be the focus for a programme of events which we've called Sea Britain 2005. That programme of events, which involves a whole range of national, regional and local organisations, is designed to widen the scope of the celebrations in 2005, to try and make people far more aware of just how important the sea is in all our lives in the UK.
Well, if any of our viewers would like to find out more, how can they do that?
They can go straight to our new website, which is www.seabritain2005.com. which has all the information about the campaign, including the Trafalgar Bicentenary, and also contact details for the team here in the UK.
Well, speaking of celebrations, back here at Trafalgar Square, there are so many surrounding attractions. Piccadilly Circus, Leicester Square, Green Park and the River Thames, they're all just a short stroll away. Around its borders, you'll find the National Gallery, housing one of the greatest collections of European painting in the world, and St Martin's in the Field, the picturesque church that was built back in 1726. spanning the River Thames and situated right next to the Tower of London, this is another of the city's numerous icons. The Tower Bridge took 8 years to build. Completed in 1894, the deck is raised on average 500 times a year for river traffic, and the high-level walkways joining the two towers were provided for pedestrians while the deck was raised. Now it appears the pedestrians are mainly tourists who clamour for a view both to and from the Tower Bridge. Now, if you enjoy shopping, no trip to London would be complete without visiting Harrods. I was fortunate enough to work here in the late 60s, would you believe, in the radio and television department. It brings back many fond memories and it continues to be an icon in the world of shopping. Many fascinating people have browsed through this department store since it opened well over a century ago. Personally, I can recall visits from the Royals to comedians such as Spike Milligan. And just 18 months ago, I was fortunate enough to meet the owner, Mr. Mohammed Al-Fayed himself. And still, celebrities are drawn to the exquisite merchandise and personalised service. So it may be more than clothes and jewellery you encounter while you shop in this magnificent store. If you've just joined us, we're on location in London, back after this break. Well, that's it for today. We hope you've enjoyed the program and our look around London. Here, the Victoria Embankment, straddling the northern side of the River Thames, also brings us plenty of familiar landmarks and attractions. Everywhere you turn in London, you'll come across another piece of history. We hope you'll soon take the journey. And remember that in 2005, it's the 200th anniversary of the Battle of Trafalgar. Until next time, stay safe and enjoy your journey.